Time to get the Cambridge perspective here in 2021. What did you guys learn about yourselves? I know that we visited during last season and trying to figure out how to do things for the 2020 year. What did you guys learn about yourselves as a team and as a coaching staff?
You know, it's just an interesting thing. I think coaches, a lot of times through that COVID, they wanted to make up everything they lost. And what we learned is kids are so resilient that we'll be okay. And really just focus on them and not worry about the football side of it. We'll catch up with that. They want to catch up. We want to catch up, but we can't force that. And so we just kind of took a relaxed approach to it, and it ended up relaxing our kids. Our kids played better. So it was interesting for us to learn that.
When you look at this year, I know that it's about as close to as normal a spring and summer as you could get. What are some of your takeaways from spring and summer and 7-on-7, that kind of stuff?
It's kind of the same thing. You know, we have a lot of kids that play different sports. So in the summer, you know, if a kid said, "Coach, I got a lacrosse tournament this week, I'm not going to be there." 2 years ago, we may have lost our minds, right? Now we're like, okay, go have fun and be a kid. And they have bought in more this year than they have when we were drilling them, "Hey, you got to be here every single day." So just kind of the same thing. Like, we just took a relaxed approach. I mean, we work hard. I mean, our kids work extremely hard, but it's okay if they miss a day or two.
When you look at your schedule, I look at it like three separate schedules. Season one, your non-region, gets you ready for season two, which gets you ready for season three, which last year for you was Buford.
Yes, sir.
That's an interesting season three for you.
You'll get ready for that.
No. But when you look at your season one this year, when you look at that first season to get you out of the blocks, what do you see in that non-region schedule?
It's a tough group. We got South Forsyth, who's been a perennial powerhouse in 7A. They've done a great job. Then we got North Oconee, who's been a really good team in 4A. So it's and then Forsyth Central, who's unique because they run a little different offense, kind of like the Georgia Tech model in the past. So it's trying to get our kids ready and them understanding that doesn't really mean anything if we lose those games. Obviously, we don't want to, but it's okay as long as we're getting better week to week. And so we kind of approach it with scrimmages and those first three games is, hey, let's get better and let's focus on us for that second set of season, as you say. So.